Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. So today I'm here to set up some of the other little schedules that I like to track for my budget. And I'm also going to stuff my cash dividers. I did not do this last month. I didn't film it last month. I did still have cash dividers and all of that, but just because of timing and everything, I didn't get around to it. So this is a little bit late, but we're gonna go ahead and do it anyway. So I'm gonna first set up my additional schedules. And I figured before I did that, I could quickly just show you guys what my plans are for this planner, because there is a different layout. If you did get the new deluxe monthly, there is a slight difference. And I just figured I'd show you guys really quickly for those of you who may be new or just not super familiar with my setup. So, as always, you have a blank page before the start of the month. This is where I like to track my variable income. So anything that results from my YouTube channel, from Etsy, from all of that goes here. And I don't actually have a variable income thing cut, so I'm gonna have to do that later and fill that in. And then you have a quote page, which I don't really normally do anything with. It's just there. I have talked about it before in some of my other planner videos, but I don't really care for quote pages. Like, that's not going to motivate me. I'm sure it's different for everybody, but occasionally if I need more space, like if this doesn't cut it, then I will put a little bit here. Like, I'll, you know, just write wherever I need to, or just put sticky notes or whatever. This is where it's a little different, and I'm still debating what I'm gonna do with this section. I was thinking about maybe doing something with like beginning and ending balances of bank accounts or savings accounts, and I just haven't really thought hard about it. So I'm probably not going to use it for July and maybe start using it in August. We'll see. And then we have the monthly view, which is where I track a lot of my budget items. So you can see I already have Jason's Ace things in there, and that's just a reminder for me so I remember to actually check and see what they are. And once we have some, you know, expenses going in here, everything will be in here. Here's where I'll do my weekly check-in, and I have that, so I'm gonna set that up today. And then we have our budget, we have our sinking funds, and our transaction log. And you could probably already see, because of the timing of when I stopped using our June sinking funds, we do have some actual June expenses here. And I may consider doing this going forward, just because the timing is so goofy. Not being able to put the beginning and like see where we're at is kind of hard. So I may continue doing it out really nicely this way. So that's all that we have, because then you get into the August pages. This really works for me. I think I, you know, for a while I was considering getting the larger planner. This is the 7x9 Erin Condren Deluxe Monthly Planner. That's a mouthful. I was considering getting the larger version, but now that I'm splitting my expenses between fixed and variable, it's really giving me more space. And I prefer the smaller one just because it's easier to carry. It's not so bulky, so I'm gonna stick with that for now. But let's go ahead and do our weekly setup. I never feel 100% ready for the month until all these schedules are done, so I'm a little bummed that I didn't think ahead of time and grab the and cut an extra one of the variable expenses, but that's something that I can easily do once I'm done filming for today and orders are out. Like, that's not a super time sensitive thing. So if you haven't already checked out my kits, these are all kits by me. Everything that you see that I use for my budget, I make myself, which is super exciting. I never thought that this would happen. It wasn't super planned, but I have to say I've been loving every second of being an Etsy shop owner, so that is something that's really fun. Just keep in mind, so July stuff is still in the shop. The middle of July, I will be taking July stuff down. So if you haven't already picked it up, but you want to, definitely pick it up. And August stuff is now in the shop, but I'm switching more to like an inventory system. So as things sell out, I won't restock them until I actually cut them. So I'm gonna need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Wait, do I need 5? I need groceries, gas, eating out healthy, I need 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So just kind of keep that in mind. And I will be going on vacation for my sister's baby shower. And so all of that, I think I talked about in my August release video. So definitely go check that out if you haven't already. And I'm gearing up for September. So it's just a lot going on with the sticker stuff. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But it's all like super fun and exciting. So June, I like obviously haven't done my results video yet, but I was going through last night and just filling in income, filling in some of our, you know, stuff that I don't really show. And I think considering how, like when I was planning it out, it didn't seem like it was gonna be that great of a month in terms of savings, it's actually not that bad. So that's something that's kind of nice. I think, you know, just the medical expenses, and I talked about this too, like I announced I'm pregnant, so that's kind of why I've had so many doctor's bills and stuff lately. But I mean, that's just gonna continue until I hit my out of pocket. So I anticipate continuing to have to add a lot of money to my out of pocket stuff, to my medical situation, but that's okay. I mean, I knew that when I went into it. I just really don't want to put like a full $1,500 in that when it's not something that we need right now. You know, like obviously as time goes on, we will add it, but you don't need to have the money in there right now. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I'm just gonna do to week 4, and I probably should have checked to see. There's 1, 2, 3, yeah, so that'll be perfect. And then I'm going to put in my weekly check-in script at the top. And draw my little lines, and then we can move on to the cash divider stuff. Okay, so that's all set up to go. I always feel so much better once that is done. And the last thing that I'll need, obviously, is the variable income, but that's all good to go. I'll do that later. I am using this erasable pen. I always have these linked down below. And I've used it now for a couple months, but like it is my go-to pen because with budgeting, you know, things change. And I'm starting to be a little bit more lenient where like if something comes up and I'm like, you know what? $500 for groceries are not going to do it. Like we're going to have people over, whatever. So the nice thing about it is you could always adjust it. So let's say I know I'm going to have people over. I could change it to $550 or something like that. I don't think I've done that yet, but it is a nice option to have. And budgets shouldn't, in my mind, and again, you can have your own thoughts on this, but budgets in my mind should not be like this static thing. Like, you know, your life changes all the time, your situations change all the time. So I personally think that like if you need to adjust your budget down or up, that's okay. It's not going to be any different than you being unbudgeted or over budget. It's as long as you're not taking advantage of it, in my opinion, I feel like it's not the right way, it's not the wrong way. It's whatever works for you guys. So again, I haven't done that yet, but that is an option when you have these types of pens. Okay, so I have a ton of money that I need to put into the bank. Jason has been saving up his allowance for a smoker, which is kind of interesting, but he has been, I mean, he's a big griller. We have people over quite a bit and grill. We also, Jason grills for us quite a bit. So it's not something that's super uncommon, but he saved his allowance and bought like a $600 grill, which is amazing. Like he obviously saved for a long time for that. But I do have a whole stack of cash in my wallet. So I need to divide it into the sections that we have. And then I need to put the rest of it in the bank because I don't like walking around with this type of money in my thing. Okay, so I'm gonna flip this over just so that we can see what amounts we're gonna need. I already gave myself my allowance, so I'm going to just put out Jason's and just remember to give that to him. So 20, 40, 60, 80. Our allowances are based off of the number of Fridays in the month. So if there are 4 Fridays in the month and we get $20 every week for an allowance, that's $80. So that will go to Jason. And then we can go ahead and do our eating out. So eating out is 200, so 20, 40, 60, 80, 100, 20, 40, 60, 80, 100. I'm just gonna make sure that that's correct because he does have some sticky bills in here. 20, 40, 60, 80, 100, 20, 40, 60, 80, 100. So that will go into our eating out divider. And then next will be household. So for household, I am giving us $100. So 20, 40, 60, 80, 100. And again, I'm just gonna double check because again, they're super sticky. 20, 40, 60, 80, 100. Not sticky, but like they're like fresh. So just feel like you have to be a little bit more careful. And then next is hair. Haircuts are $30. And I'm gonna see if he has, let's see. Doesn't look, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Doesn't look like he's gonna have the right change for this. So, I think what I'm gonna do, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Wait, no, I think we're good. So that's 10, 20, 30, okay. I think we're good. So 15 will go to Jason. So I'm actually gonna give that right to him with his allowance. And then 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 will go in my divider. Recently, I've been giving him his allowance and haircut money together. He's super good with keeping stuff separate, so I don't have to worry about that. So the rest of this money can go into the bank along with some checks that I have. So I'm going to put that in my little section for that. And then I can put the rest of this into my wallet and we're all good to go for July. This is another thing that I do not feel ready for the month until we have our dividers because like it's messy if you, use your card and then have to like settle it later. I feel so much better once this is done. So I'm gonna go ahead and put this into my wallet. I've talked about this before. If you wanna check out my budget playlist, I have a whole playlist where I talk about these dividers and my whole system, but they fit perfectly in there and we're good to go. So that is my setup video for July. I hope you guys enjoyed watching me set the rest of the stuff up. Again, I'll have to cut some more of the variable stickers, but I'll do that and then get all set up so I can, you know, start tracking some of the stuff for my business stuff. But other than that, guys, I honestly have not set up, I seriously haven't set up any of this planner. Like, I think I have nothing here. I'm gonna tape those together because that doesn't matter for me. I need to put like where our sinking funds, when our sinking funds are coming out. Not sure what I'll do here. Maybe I'll do something with like tracking how much we have savings or something. And yeah, so I still need to figure a lot out, but once I figure it out, I will share it with you guys and let you guys know what I decided to do. But other than that, that is all for now. And I will see you guys next time. Bye guys.